Today we're going to talk about prolonged fasting and IGF number one. Now, what is IGF number one? I've done other videos on this, and it stands for insulin-like growth factor number one. It's a hormone that is made in the liver. It's stimulated by growth hormone, and it acts like growth hormone in the body. So it's kind of an extension of growth hormone. Growth hormone is made by the pituitary. It goes down the liver. It triggers the liver to make IGF. Now, IGF is vitally important to the growth and development of tissues in the body. So whatever the functions of growth hormone are, those are the same functions as IGF. And when you're not eating, insulin goes down, IGF goes up to mobilize fat to actually give you fuel. So it's one of the fat-burning hormones. So it's a vital hormone. But when you look through the research on this, there's an association to increasing the risk of cancer if IGF is too high. Now, it's not that IGF number one is not the sole cause of cancer. It's involved in cancer because it's an anabolic hormone. It makes things grow, and it inhibits something called apoptosis. So this is where certain cells, like cancer cells, commit suicide. Well, IGF number one can inhibit that. So that can kind of counter your body's ability to get rid of cancer. So it's known to promote cancer, prostate, breast, liver cancer. But you have to realize there's a lot of other things that have to happen in your body for you to get cancer. Definitely, you have to have damage to the mitochondria. You have to have a shift in that metabolism to fermenting glucose. So the only reason I'm bringing this up is to show you another huge benefit that occurs when you do prolonged fasting. As I mentioned before, when you don't eat, insulin goes down, and then the IGF number one goes up. So when you fast for 3 to 5 days, you get a pretty good decrease in IGF number one, like a 30% decrease. You're also getting a major decrease in glucose. You're tapping out your glycogen reserve in your liver. You're decreasing insulin. So your immune system starts to thrive. Your inflammation goes down, which is always connected to the spread of cancer. And you have all sorts of amazing neuroregenerative things that happen, like your brain cells start growing. Also, if you have PCOS, this is essential to do periodically. When you do a fast for greater than 5 days, when you get into 5 to 7 days or even longer, you create a much deeper drop in IGF number one, like a 60% drop. Also, you get a massive drop in glucose and insulin. So you just created an environment in your body where cancer just absolutely cannot exist. Not only are you starving it its fuel and glutamate, which is an amino acid that can fuel cancer too, so you're not consuming any glutamate, so that's going to be down, and you're dropping IGF number one. So you're going to make it next to impossible for cancer cells to survive. Also, you're going to find that you're going to clear up diabetes type 2, and you're basically just going to live longer. So doing a longer fast every so often is extremely therapeutic to your body. Now, if anyone tells you that prolonged fasting is harmful to your body or it's starving, I'm going to put some links down below for you to just look at to show you that it's absolutely really good for your survival of your cells to do periodic prolonged fasting. Now, if you've never done it before, you want to ease up into it and gradually do it, and definitely take nutrients while you're fasting. But you're going to find that after a day or two, your hunger is going to be completely gone. You're going to have energy. Your cognitive function is going to go up. It's going to be very, very beneficial. At 3 days into your fast, your cells start to resist stress and toxins, so they become stronger, which is just a survival mechanism. It's quite fascinating. The point of this video is just to increase your awareness on the benefits of prolonged fasting periodically, especially for cancer, and also just to make you aware of what's happening with IGF. This is not a bad hormone. It's just that when you do fasting, you're not just merely starving the cancer of fuel. You're doing some other very powerful things as well. Thanks for watching. Before you go, if you have a question about a product, or you're new to keto and you want to know how to begin keto, or you're on keto and you need a debug because it's not going as smooth, I have a keto consultant standing by to help you. This is just for the people in the US, Hopefully in the future, we'll be able to answer everyone's call. But I put the number down below so you can call and get some help.